Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and today's video even, I am bringing you Gump news, because a lot has happened this week and I just thought today was the perfect opportunity to bring to you. Nah, I really need like a jingle or something for this because I can't just be doing this. Okay, so let's just get straight into the video. Obviously I'm going to be holding my phone throughout this video just because notes, facts and everything is on this device. If I need some answers, I'm using Google, so let's get straight into it. So over the past couple of days, one of the major news that's been happening or being said even is the news that 21 Savage is from the UK. He was born in London, he ain't from Atlanta. Now for those who don't know who 21 Savage is, 21 Savage is a popular Atlanta, or now London, rapper. 21 Savage is best known for his popular songs such as Bank Account, X and No Heart. He is also known for being in a relationship with Amber Rose, and if you haven't seen pictures already, he did partake in Amber Rose's slut walk and he was proudly holding up his sign. Who would have asked for a better boyfriend, eh? Now a couple of days ago it made news and it was trending worldwide on Twitter that 21 Savage had been arrested by ICE and was held under custody because his visa papers ran out 10-13 years ago and he was illegally staying in the US. That day that all happened, let me tell you guys a little mini story. That day, the day that I even got this ponytail made, shout out Donna. That day, I was in the bathroom, I was washing my hair, relaxing my hair. Obviously, I'm listening to music on my phone, but my phone kept on vibrating, like literally constantly vibrating. And I'm just thinking to myself, like, I know my phone isn't ringing because I'm listening to music, but why is my phone vibrating? Obviously now, I see that I've just got loads of Twitter notifications, and it said, yeah, he's from Blenheim Gardens. I was thinking, what did I say that I said mention Blenheim Gardens? Blenheim Gardens is a part in South London next to Brixton. It's on Brixton Hill, Blenheim Gardens, that's where Blenheim Gardens is. On the 22nd of April 2018, one boy made a tweet saying, the fact 21 Savage grew up in London but acts like he never, what? The fact 21 Savage grew up in London but acts like he never is mad weird, man. So obviously I saw this tweet kind of blew up. I knew 21 Savage is from Brixton, so I quote tweeted the tweet, and the tweet that everyone's like, I mean, was retweeting saying, yeah, he's from Blenheim Gardens, was a quote tweet to that. Now, the reason why I knew that 21 Savage was from Brixton Hill is because one of my good friends, Lenny, shout out Lenz, he is good friends with 21 Savage's brother. Now, when Lenny told me originally that 21 is from Brixton Hill, I was like most people that found out the other day, nah, how can he be from London, this and that. Even that day in April, there was loads of people that were like, ah, you guys are begging there, how is he from London, he's from Atlanta, this and that. Like, literally, I was completely like you guys. I was thinking, nah, this guy is not from London, what the hell? And if he is from London, why is he from South London, Southwest London, Brixton Hill? Just a small Brixton Hill, you know, like, think to myself, how is 21 Savage, a big 21 Savage? And even at the time when I did find this out, 21 Savage wasn't as big as he was now. Like, he wasn't even going out with Amber Rose at this time. This is literally when he had just dropped No Heart. Yeah, this was around the time he dropped No Heart. Yeah, so obviously now Lenny's like, nah, like, I'm good. His grandma is still on ends. Like, his nan is still on the ends. The boy is local. 21 Savage is from Brixton Hill. Cool. So I saw the evidence that I needed to see, yes, 21 Savage is actually from Brixton Hill. Now that tweet that I put up blew up so crazy. Like, it reached American Twitter. There were people from America tweeting me saying, oh, Millennium Gardens is that, can you please tell me if this is some type of hood or is this type of some type of ghetto? Like, America's really wanted that reassurance that, rah, like, this guy is hood. Because people started now downplaying my guy 21. They were downplaying him. The ignorance was shown in America, from America, like, the ignorance was really shown. Like, people, now that they heard that he was born in the UK, that he lost his streets, everyone here is moist or something like that. The tweets that I was seeing was absolutely ridiculous. The tweet blew up so bad, my sister messaged me the other day. I was like, my tweet was featured on Philip DeFranco's YouTube video. I was like, if you don't know who Philip DeFranco is, he's very, very popular YouTuber. My tweet was there, so. But yes, 21 Savage is currently under custody right now. I think ICE are really out here to deport him back into the UK. My thing is, now personally, I don't want him to come back. And it's not like I don't want him to come back because, like, I don't want him to come back. I just feel like the guy actually moved to America when he was like five, six, 7 years old. He's made his life there, he's made his friends, he grew up there. He was raised in Atlanta. That's his family. All his family and friends are there. It would just be a bit crazy for him to come back now to the UK and have people like these UK rappers trying to beg it with him, making 21 Savage jump on drill. This guy's never jumping on drill, okay? He's never jumping on drill. Let's get it right. But for me, the whole thing was a little bit fishy because even though I had the knowledge and understanding that from a while ago that 21 Savage is from London, I just thought it was a bit fishy to me because he only got arrested and detained after a performance that he did. I think it was on Saturday Night Live. He performed at a Saturday Night Live and he performed a lot and he added an extra verse from a lot. And in this verse, he was talking about like immigration, in the immigration system in America, things like that. Then he conveniently got arrested and detained. This guy literally talks and sings and raps about murder, trapping, everything. This is the same guy. 21 Savage is the same person. I'm sure he has that song. I'm on that slaughter gang shit. Murder gang shit. Nah, let me. This is the music this guy is happily rapping about and was rapping about. And he had never been looked at in his background once. This guy who has guns and things like that, never been looked at once. But the day that he starts singing about immigration in America is the day that he gets arrested. Something's a bit fishy. Americans, I don't know what's wrong with your country then, but you guys are not really trying to see people shine. You guys want people out of here. But listen, by God's grace and everything and the right lawyers, 21 will be able to stay in America and this will just be a dream. Not a dream, but this will be forgotten about. That's that on the 21 Savage news. Now the next news is the news of Liam Neeson. If you don't know who Liam Neeson is, Liam Neeson is most popular for being the guy from Taken. He is the main actor in Taken and most notable for his famous scene.
If you let my daughter go now, that'll be the end of it. I will not look for you. I will not pursue you. But if you don't, I will look for you. I will find you. And I will kill you.
That's Liam Neeson. Solid guy, solid actor. I was rooting for this guy all the way. Until. So if you've been living under a rock, in a recent interview, Liam Neeson came on to promote his new film. And in this interview, he decided to share with us his horrible past, saying that he had major regrets from his horrible past and he wanted to share it. Bearing in mind, nobody, not one person, asked him to share this tale. So bearing in mind, this could be a good tale. So everyone's listening, everyone's here. Oh, did this guy not shock us? Did this guy not shock us? Now in this interview, he shared that how somebody he knew, he didn't tell us if it was like a family or a friend, but someone he knew, a female, was raped and she handled the situation very, very well, but it rubbed him the wrong way. So when asking the girl if she knew who he was, she said no. Then Liam Neeson decided to ask her what race was the guy, and she said the guy was black. When he had this knowledge and understanding that the boy that raped the girl was black, this rubbed him very, very differently that he decided to go on a black people hunt. I went up and down areas with a crowbar hoping I'd be approached by somebody. I'm ashamed to say that, and I did it for maybe hoping some black bastard, and this is what he done with his fingers, black bastard. So he said, hoping some black bastard will come out of a pub and have a go at me about something, you know, so that I could kill him. This guy is genuinely telling us this story like, oh yeah, because you know, he doesn't go down in the street looking for black people to kill, like I'm a member of the KKK or something like that. He goes on to say that it took him a week to process this whole horrible event that has happened, and he was really out to seek some revenge. After this week, he then decided, bro, what the fuck are you doing? What are you doing? And he goes on to say that he went to look for help, and he went to seek help, and he's not a racist, and this was a dark and chilling time that happened to him 40 years ago. My thing is now, nobody asked him to share this. Not one person asked him to share this story. Not one person. And in this day and age of 2019, I don't understand how he felt open to express, like, yeah, I used to go on a hunt looking for black people. Are you, as in, bro, in 2019 you feel like you can say the story? And I feel like in his head he was probably thinking, oh, he's backed himself, he saved himself by saying, yeah, but I went to seek some help. No, nigga, you are cancelled. Nah, he is actually cancelled. And that one made me sad, because I actually really like Liam Neeson. I like his films. Like, he was in Ted, he was in Dark Knight Rises, he was in the Chronicles of Narnia? Well, I just said Narnia, but I was just gonna say the full thing, you know. This guy was rude for him, and then he went to make a comment like that. Ack. Liam Neeson. Get sued. But yeah, no, this was actually a short segment of Gump News. These were just two big stories that I actually wanted to talk to you guys about. I was going to talk briefly about the 6ix9ine thing, but that one is just, I think that is just public knowledge that 6ix9ine is a snitch, you know. Fun fact, I was in the studio with 6ix9ine when he created that tune with Fetty Wap. Me and Jessica. Jessica one day will jump on my channel and tell you a story to have about 6ix9ine. But yeah, before 6ix9ine was even 6ix9ine, I met him. I was in the studio with him. I missed Fetty Wap by like 20 minutes, but I was in the studio when this guy recorded this banger. Yeah, that song. I just wanted to do a little classic name drop, like, yeah, met 6ix9ine, you know what I mean? I was going to talk about 6ix9ine, but I'm not going to do so because everybody knows he is nerd. Thank you for watching my video, and thank you for tuning into Gump News. If you made it this far, you are real MVP. Real MVP. Send me your account details. £10 in your account tonight, clear. If you wanna keep up to date with me and everything like that, follow me on all my socials, my Instagram, my Twitter, my Snapchat, all Steph Gump and everything like that. If you liked Gump News, let me know anywhere. And as long as I get feedback and I know what you guys like, I wanna see, then I will do it. But yeah guys, I hope to see you in my next video. Yeah, everyone have a great day, everybody have a great week wherever you're watching this, and I'll see you soon. I like it, I want it, I got it, I want it, I got it, I want it, I got it.